The next item is item number 12. This is a public hearing also on a specific use permit, SUP 070019. It's a request for a specific use permit for a church on one lot on 9.5 acres on the east side of Independence Parkway, 1,300 feet north of El Dorado Parkway, and to consider an act to direct staff to prepare an ordinance of the same. This is zoned agriculture, agricultural with a specific use permit S-72 for a commercial plant nursery and a specific use permit S-108 for a metal building. Scott?
You have before you a request for a church religious facility to be located on these approximately 9.5 acres. The property is currently zoned agricultural. They have submitted a request at the request of staff to rezone the property to single family four. That will be heard before the Planning and Zoning Commission, I believe next week. The Planning and Zoning Commission did hold a public hearing up on this request at the December 11th meeting, and they did vote 5-0 to recommend approval to the City Council. There was an adjacent property owner, that's the property owner here along the north side, who has submitted written opposition to the request. For that reason, under Article 1 of the Comprehensive Zoning Ordinance, because there is a property owner who has property directly adjacent to the request that exceeds 20%, and then in this case approximately 25%, that any action to approve the request will require that the City Council have a supermajority vote,
which is 5 out of 6 of the council members must vote to approve it. Any other comments before we open the
public hearing? No, I have no comments. We'll try and answer any questions you might have.
All right, Scott, we'll ask maybe questions of you as we get into this.
What? I'm going to move to open the public hearing, but I'd like to make a request. I've spoken with the applicant. If we can have her speak first and then the gentleman that triggered the supermajority to speak after that, it may save quite a bit of time and a lot of these people can go home, that we may have an agreement.
And her name is?
I'm
getting in here.
It's
Lakshmi.
Yeah, Lakshmi, thank you. I was getting ready to pull it up.
Here. Open public hearing.
Second.
We have a motion by Jim to open the public hearing, and a second by Jeff. All in favor?
Aye. Aye.
Any opposed? Motion passes 6-0. Okay, so would you like to come speak first, ma'am?
Sure.
Okay. Would you give your name?
Yes. My name is Lakshmi Tamala, and Happy New Year.
Happy and, good and, your, evening. And your address, if you would, for the record.
Sure. I'm speaking on behalf of Data Yoga Center, so 12030 Independence Parkway, Frisco 75035. My name is Lakshmi Tamala, and I'm speaking to you today on behalf of Data Yoga Center. I've lived in the Dallas-Fort Worth area for 10 years, and like many of you, I grew up in the South, born in Jackson, Mississippi, and grew up in, born in Memphis, Tennessee, grew up in Jackson, Mississippi. I'm married, have two young boys who go to Frisco School District Schools, wonderful schools. I'm a licensed CPA in the state of Texas, practicing, and for the last 4 years, I've also been doing residential real estate. As we all know, Frisco is one of the most culturally, religiously, and socially diverse cities in the Metroplex, and it's for this reason that most of my clients, many of them, have chosen Frisco to call home. Our group is called Data Yoga Center, or DYC. These days, yoga is mainly associated with a form of exercise. However, the true meaning of the word yoga dates back thousands of years, and it means union with God. There are many types of yoga. Meditation is one form of yoga. Living your life in a good and pure way is another form of yoga. Having unwavering faith in a higher being is another form of yoga. And if someone were to do all of these forms of yoga together, they would live a strong and peaceful life. DYC is a center that fosters the principle and the true meaning of the word yoga. Some background, DYC is a charitable organization registered with the IRS in the United States for the last 20 years, with small centers in Pennsylvania and Louisiana. We have worldwide organizations, worldwide presence in countries such as Germany, India, Switzerland, Malaysia, Trinidad, Canada, and the UK, just to name a few. We look forward to building a place of worship here in Frisco, which will benefit the city as well as its residents. And as you can see by the number of supporters here today, this is a project that's important to many people. The population that DYC would attract to Frisco are hardworking, well-educated professionals such as doctors, dentists, nurses, engineers, CPAs, and business entrepreneurs. And many of them will choose to make Frisco home because they would like to be closer to this temple. And many other people will come from Plano, McKinney, Allen, Carrollton to visit the temple, and they'll spend time in Frisco shopping, dining, and just really learning to love Frisco like we all do. And DYC has a strong history of giving, and as we become part of the Frisco community, we look forward to supporting the people and the projects and future of Frisco. On the advice of Gail Stafford from City Planning, we held a neighborhood meeting, and one objection was raised regarding traffic. This particular piece of land is on Independence, which is a major thoroughfare per City Planning. So that's one of the reasons that we like this land. We are across from a middle school, a proposed high school that's under construction, a church, residential neighborhood. So we understand traffic, but we don't feel that we're a major cause for this traffic. And I'd like to take this opportunity to invite all of you to visit our facility when it's up and running. We have an open door policy, and you are all welcome. We'd love to have you. In fact, we've already had a good amount of interest just from people that are curious to learn a little bit more, and also curious to learn yoga in its traditional form, which we do plan to teach on the facility. We're really excited about becoming a part of Frisco. We've already met many of our neighbors, including Rejoice Lutheran Church, and they've been very welcoming. We look forward to enhancing this community with our neighbors and being a part of Frisco. We have with us today the national president of our organization, and he and I are here to answer any questions that you may have. I'd also like to mention that before this meeting, we had met the landowner to the north, and I have had a chance to speak, and he has said that if we are willing to build an 8-foot masonry wall between our property and his, that he would be willing to withdraw his objection. And we would just like to say that if the council feels that that's a fair request and that that's something that we should do, that we would be happy to honor his request if you feel that that's a fair and good request. And we have many supporters here today, many who have come prepared to speak, and we'd like to give them an opportunity now to stand up and show their support, and then if they would like to speak in the future. So all those in support, could you please stand at this time?
Don't have them all leave at one time. we'll have a stampede. So. We do appreciate all of those of you who came tonight in support of this to stand up, and I appreciate you utilizing that method of showing the support. We do have a total of 41 people who have signed a blue card indicating they are in support of this but who do not wish to speak. In addition, we have 21 people who have signed up that are in support and do wish to speak. But in reference to the comment made by our Mayor Pro Tem, Jim Joyner, we'll now hear from the one person who's in opposition to this. However, before we do that, that would mean we'd have to close the public hearing. So if we're going to close the public hearing, for those in favor, we don't have to. I guess I can take it that way.
Yeah.
I can do it that way. Excuse me. I was thinking I would have to close it and then ask for those again who were opposed to it. My mistake. So, Antonio, I guess would you like to come forward and speak?
That way also, if it's worked out right now, those of you that came to speak can if you wish, but you can also go home and be with your families if you wish.
Well, first of all, good evening.
Happy New Year.
You have to do the same. You have to say your name and your address.
Okay, Antonio Carlos Pecorari, or my address is 11900 Independence, Frisco. I thought it was going to be simple. As we discussed in the back, I was not prepared to make a long speech, but also, you know, I think she went a little farther, so I feel necessary for also for me to explain, you know, my concerns I have. I believe if everything is under the law, okay, I'd have to have no problems with, okay? One of the major points I brought early on was traffic, okay? And it's going to be six developments around that area. It's probably going to be around 1,200 to 1,500 homes. And if you double two cars per house, we're talking about a large number of cars will be driving in Independence and El Dorado. Plus with the school, okay, with the middle school and with the high school, you know, that and with the open up of the tollway, it makes El Dorado a very traffic area. So that was my concern. And it's only one opposition at this moment because there's no neighbors around. There is no homes around, you know, the site proposed. So that was the reason I have some concerns, okay? Disappoints me with the city because I asked them to do a traffic study to make sure my worries was unfound. And unfortunately, it was no traffic study done. That kind of disappoints me. But, you know, I guess you folks have more experience than I do in this business, so you guys will have a good idea what it really is going on there. My next concern was going to be parking, but it seems like they fulfilled that, so I have no issues with parking. Definitely, I do have issues with overflowing parking. Okay, the moment is if it's a little bit, you know, more, then where are they going to park? Okay, because I definitely don't want them to park next in front of my house. Will create tremendous problems for me to get in and out, who's already an issue with the middle school. Okay, so that was one of the concerns I have. Okay, and also there's a neighborhood in the back who is a traffic. It's going to be traffic coming out of the church, but going through. But the city does not see a problem with that. So, you know, I'm not going. If this is under the law, you know, I'm not here to go against. So basically, there are concerns. That was the reason why I'm opposing. My family and we're religious people. There's no way we were trying to stop a temple or a church. Okay, so that's not the reason we're here. Unfortunately, the last meeting, it got a little personal where people believing, you know, we're the enemies. We're not the enemies. The American is a beautiful country where everybody has rights. The temple have rights, but also as a taxpayer and a property owner, I also have rights. And you know, based on that, I think it's more than reasonable for them to have a separation, an 8-foot fence and a wall there, to kind of shield, you know, the property, the temple, for my property, okay? For you know, insurance reasons, you know, already been my agent when he spoke to me to try to, you have to double up your premium already because that also, you know, there I didn't brought this in the back there. It is an issue for me, and I will. That's not a deal breaker, but also the architecture of the property, you know, is a little bit out of the normal Texans USA look of a church or a temple. So if they could tone down a little bit and make it a little bit more Texas-like, where you know people will not make my property, because I live in the property, but I also have 10 acres next door. I want to also that property eventually I'm going to have to develop. And I wanted that property to be desirable for people eventually in the future. So to me, there's a two requests. First of all, is definitely the fence. Okay, that's very important. And second, if they could just tone down a little bit the design, and I think we can work on that also. based on those two, and if they under the law, they're welcome, and my family and myself were very happy to take it away our objection to the project.
Okay. Thank you very much. So you're saying that you, Scott, would need to provide a written withdrawal of this protest? No. All right. But your withdrawal of your opposition to this would be based upon the 8-foot wall fence.
Yes, sir.
And I guess I'll say toning down the design. I'm trying to understand what that means. Let me just say this, and excuse me for interrupting, but as I read the backup material, the buildings are going to be a maximum of two stories high. But there would be a monument, or not a monument, a how was it referred to? There would be an entrance. There's two places in here that did I read they would be 40 foot high? That's what I was trying to read, how high they would be.
The maximum height of the structure is 40 feet, but as the comprehensive zoning ordinance allows, it does allow for architectural features to extend above that. Now, architectural features are such things as, for example, for a church, it can be a spire or a cross, say, that exceeds the 40 feet in height. Maybe on a commercial building, it may be a parapet wall that has some unique design to it. We deal with those pretty much day in and day out. That's nothing that we haven't seen before. We work with that.
Okay, I'm just looking at, what I'm trying to do is understand what the toning down means. In the drawing, there's a, I wish I could read it.
Do you have the design there?
Do we have any facade plans?
I have a design there that I can show to you if you like it, if you permit.
I see this from the drawing. I'm just trying to determine on the two, as you go from this smaller building and
you can go ahead and bring those up.
As you go back towards where the second building will be, there will be a, This is what would be.
I didn't see anything about stairs.
So Scott, I don't know if you can tell this. So these two devices here could be how high? These two pieces that would go in front of the second building. Can you tell from what I'm talking about there?
Yes, I can. I can see it from here. But we do try and and work with them to keep a maximum height so that it's not an obvious intrusion into the adjacent properties.
Does the applicant have some information on that?
Right now, those are drawn at 40 feet high just because that's what the city had recommended. And we've tried to accommodate so far everything that the city has recommended. So we have limited that to 40 feet.
So that, according to this drawing, if in fact you do it this way, it would be about the size of what is in the second building, the highest portions of the second building.
That's correct. And those are non-occupiable 40 feet.
Okay.
And so you'd agree to limiting those then to 40 feet?
Yes, they're already drawn at 40 feet. Okay. That's right.
I think, were you asking the person opposing this? Or are you asking her?
I was asking her if they would be willing to agree to limit that to 40 feet.
Yes, and that's correct. And what you see in front of you does show that, 40 feet only.
Okay, so did you want... Scott, do you need to answer the question as to why we did not do a traffic study? He had a question about that.
The zoning ordinance has in it baselines that are used to determine, a kind of a threshold when a impact or traffic impact analysis is necessary. The proposed use was very low as far as traffic generation and did not come close to triggering that requirement. To my knowledge, there are very few businesses, churches, facilities that we do require traffic impact analysis unless it's in like a major shopping center or something like that.
I work at Roach Middle School, so I know what the traffic is like. And is it just because it's at certain times the traffic is that bad?
You've got two things going there right now. One is you only have the west north-south lanes of Independence. This project, when it comes in, will be required to construct the two on eastbound lane, or the two lanes on the east side, which will then allow the traffic to flip, and you'd have two lanes going north, two lanes going south. So essentially, you're doubling your capacity, or even more so on that. The other is that you only have a certain time of the day when that is, you know, typically in the morning and in the evening, with probably the morning being the heaviest. Again, those are very limited. Churches, for the most part, do not operate on the same time periods as, say, schools or even shopping centers, for that matter. Those typically, the peak times are, you know, for a school, it's first thing in the morning, you know, and then at 3:30, 4 o'clock in the afternoon. And I'm saying churches, but I'm, you know, again, talking about all religious group facilities. You know, they're looking at, you know, their time spread out, even to the point of being a lot of facilities are only have their heaviest on like on a Saturday or a Sunday, which would be opposite of what the school is.
And this facility is operational that way, or?
I'm just assuming that. You know, we have, that's not really part of what we get into as far as what hours of operation or anything like that. They could, I think the applicant could probably give you a much better response than I would be able to.
So do you want, is that a question you have?
Well, it is. I didn't know if you wanted me to wait until after the public hearing.
Okay, we can, thank you. Any other questions?
To me, this is only one point. It is 40 feet. It seems pretty high. For this, if it's the construction, it seems like it's okay. But if it's any monumental, you know, statues and things like that, at 40 feet, it seems a little, you know, odd. But, you know, I think we can, I think this is something, you know, I request a table in this so we'll have the opportunity to talk to them. They do not wish to do that. Okay, so, you know, basically, you know, I didn't want, and I forgot to mention this in the back there, be honest with you. When I sit down, that's what it came to my mind. You know, the wall is fantastic, but also the architecture was one of my number one issues also. So, and I don't want to sidetrack them because I agree something in the back. So, you know, but, so I'm in a dwelling position here right now because I agree something in the back.
Well, and the reason I'm asking the questions is it's important for us to know if you're going to withdraw that. It's important for us to know that because, Rebecca, does that change whether we need a supermajority or a majority?
Yes.
So,
yes.
So the reason I keep questioning you is I don't want you to agree to something that you're not really agreeing to before we take a vote on this. And then, depending upon where you stand on this, there's 20 other people who wish to speak. So,
no, I'm sorry, I didn't mean to interrupt you. Like I said, if it is 8-foot fence wall is there, then my family and myself will agree to it. Okay, we know the First Amendment, you know, what, you know, if everything is under the law, you know, you're required to fulfill the request anyway. What I'm trying to hear is, if there is a protection on an 8-foot fence wall, I'm happy. And my second point is, if it could be some limitations on the structure, I'm also agree with that. But that's secondary. If, you know, if you guys says that Antonio Carlos, you know, is 8-foot fence here, you know, I guess I'll have to go with. But also, I believe, would it be nice for you guys also to put some restriction on the architecture, because that's not going to affect me, but it's going to affect everybody in the neighborhood. And at this moment, it's not other people who are here to speak for, because Whoop is already developing the houses. There's no houses there right now, so it's nobody to speak for these people. So, you know, your decision, it's not just going to affect me, but it's going to affect people who are not there yet, okay? But yes, sir, if I answer your question, yes. Assuming they fulfill all the obligations and there's 8-foot fence high, okay, you know, I will draw my objection to the project.
Okay, and to that point, I guess this is not ironclad and it may change, but in looking at this drawing, there are portions of the actual second building that would be built that would be the same height as those. So it would not be that those two pieces were above the other structure. That structure will have elements of it that would be the same height. Is that right, Scott? It can go up to 40 feet on this, yeah, on the second building.
Yeah, sir, just one point is this. There are four questions in the city request. The property is harmonious and is what is the other word? I'm sorry, I'm not American. I have a hard time with the words.
Compatible. Is the property harmonious and compatible with the surrounding existing uses or proposed uses?
And my question basically back to you all there is that compatible and harmonious what is around there? You know, and you know, I disagree with the answer from the city, because they said that it is. I've been more an American than I've been in Brazil, and I don't see many buildings like this in the United States. You know, so you know, I just want to make sure it fits in the neighborhood. I just don't want something just kind of pops out and everybody drives by and it caught tremendous attention. You know, that's my point, and my apologies if I could not explain to you properly, but that's what I'm trying to get to.
And Scott, can you address the procedure for facade plans, and does that come back to P&Z anywhere on?
A couple of things to touch upon. First of all, let me also point out that the properties around it, including the Antonio's, have a 40-foot maximum requirement, and that would include the residential subdivision that is to the east and to the south. Would also like to point out that a two-story building with the typical roof pitches that we have today is well over 30 feet. It's under 40, but it's well over 30 feet in height. So, you know, the fact is that he would be able to see roof structures that would be just as tall as, or almost as tall as the temple that's being proposed. The facade plans, approval of facade plans are a staff function. Unless this is something that is part of a plan development where there has been some standards established, facade plans are a staff function. They do not go to the Planning and Zoning Commission or to the City Council unless there is a situation where the applicant does not agree with staff and wishes to appeal staff's decision, then it would go to the Planning and Zoning Commission.
You know, so to put that 40 feet in perspective, because yours is two-story, I believe, isn't it, your home?
Yes, sir.
It's probably only anywhere from 5 to 6 feet taller than the peak of your house.
Understood. The height is a little concerns me. What I'm concerned is if it's a building, I understand. But now if it's going to look like a castle, you know, we're going to have, you know, 40-foot, you know, statue on the right, 40-foot statue on the left, then the house is in the back, and, you know, then the building is in the back, and it's a little more different, you know, architecture than in America. That's what I'm saying. You know, the height, yes, is a concern, but my concern is, you know, or it's going to be statues 40 feet high, you know, on each corner. It's going to look like a castle, because that's looks like a castle.
Scott, to that point, I mean, we're looking at SUP here. As such, we can look at issues like land use, adjoining property uses, building height. Is facade something that we can actually even take a look at in making this consideration?
The council can set through there, because this is a specific use permit, you can place conditions on it. However, I would caution you on that, as in architecture is probably one of the things that most people will never agree on. You know, what consists of even documented architecture? Is it, you know, was it a true Queen Anne Victorian house or wasn't? You know, architecture is something that is literally in the eye of the beholder. It is an area that, yes, we do not have, to my knowledge, something that is, you know, as ornate as this. But then we don't have, you know, for example, I would point to the ballpark. You know, there you have a number of spires, you have a number of pitches and the roofs, you have a number of corner elements. You know, that in and of itself is different than the architecture of the buildings around it. Even homes, you know, you can go into neighborhoods and find build houses that are different than the architecture around them. You know, again, you're getting into an area that, yes, you probably could place limitations on them, but you really should be at a point where you can quantify those limitations. And I'm not sure how you would go about doing that.
Mr. Mayor, in an attempt to get this off center, can I kind of summarize and see if we're all hearing the same thing? We're going to go with rezoning to SF4. That ensures that should the property ever be sold, not developed, the church goes away, it would be residential. Cross access and joint parking agreements in place prior to, one of your concerns is that Rejoice Lutheran might sell the property, and then, but that would be required. And those would be required to be built, correct, Scott, the cross access, even if Rejoice doesn't build before they can even open the doors. You've got a 40-foot limitation to architectural features. You are agreeable to an 8-foot masonry wall, and that is something that you would like. And then I think the applicant has said that they'd be willing to work with you, and you work with them. From what I heard, you just want to be able to work with them to make it as aesthetically pleasing as it can be while still meeting their religious criteria. I mean, because you can't ask them to build a temple for their faith based on our churches or our temples. So am I hearing that correctly? If all of those things are met, you are in agreement with this proposition?
Yes, sir. Yes. Basically, like I said, I don't want to take any way for their religious. If it was there. I just want something who belongs to the area. And I don't know how can we agree with that. And I don't know if there's anything you guys can do to help, but that's the only, you know, concern.
And you can interact with staff, too, during that period. And I'm sure they would be glad to have input from everyone.
Scott, what is staff's position on the proposed 8-foot masonry wall as far as how that would, are there any concerns with that proposal?
No. The zoning ordinance already now allows for a, you know, essentially a screening wall of 6 to 8 feet in height. So we have the 8-foot screening walls, you know, in numerous areas of the city. So that's something we're quite used to working with.
And I believe the mayor asked this, is there an official, something official he has to do to withdraw, to make this a simple majority versus supermajority? Or is his just stating it enough for us to vote?
I believe, and Rebecca can correct me if I'm wrong, but I think that if he verbally goes on record as withdrawing his opposition, that would be adequate.
It would be.
And it may be a moot point, even if it's on record and he now says he's in agreement, as long as these things are met in our motion. I'm not going to speak for the council, but I doubt that's going to be a problem. And that may keep a lot of people from having to to speak.
So, based upon what Mayor Pro Tem Joyner said, then you would withdraw your opposition. Is that correct?
Yes, sir.
Okay.
But it seems like it was no resolution on the architectural part.
Mayor, if I may interject, I am not hearing that he's willing to withdraw because there is no resolution on his concern of architectural issues and if it's compatible. I'm hearing concerns that I don't really truly hear him withdrawing his protest.
No, I don't defer with you. I withdraw my protest. The only thing is that I want some firm position from the city council or the city, okay? My concerns about the architectural part. Because then the moment I withdraw and I walk out of here, then, you know, they're building, you know, anything they want. And it's not comparable to the area. So if you guys will give me assurance, the city will give me assurance, that will be comparable to the area, I withdraw right now. I have no issues. Can you give me the assurance, you know, that will be comparable to the United States?
I think that's what staff was saying. Yeah. So challenging is differences of opinion in architecture. I just have one procedural question. If, say, for instance, we just decide to vote on this as presented and a supermajority is not reached, then at that time, could the applicant resubmit with some additional changes and it be voted on again?
Again, I think Rebecca could probably may need to answer, but if a supermajority vote, if a vote is taken and a supermajority is not obtained, then essentially the request is denied.
And don't we have a time period for resubmitting? I cannot recall.
Only if it's with prejudice.
Okay.
So if it's just a failure to obtain a supermajority and it's not a denial per se, the request is in fact denied, they essentially could come in tomorrow morning with a new application.
Okay. You know, the next option, and I don't know if you'd be agreeable with, I'm not gonna create problems, okay? So let's table this and back in 2 weeks and let us decide the architectural part and the wall. And I have no, you know, you have my word, I'm not gonna go back. And I'm not using no tricks to do anything in 14 days. Basically, you know, there's one of the issues I have. If they can kind of make this go away at this moment, you know, I withdraw without no issues. So, you know, I don't want to create another problem then for them to have to submit something, you know, and create more problems to something I'm 99.9% to agree. You know,
okay, but to our attorney's comment and to Scott Engel's comment, what I'm hearing our staff say and the attorney say is that if they have certain requirements that they want in monumentation or the building of their building and any ornamental features that they have, that must be done a certain way for it to meet what their requirements are, and then you're objecting to that, then there is not an agreement. And we, as a staff, our city staff, even though they can come forward and talk about what they want to do and what the design would features would be, the staff cannot necessarily say to them, you can't do that. Is that correct, Scott?
It becomes very difficult for staff to be able to say, you know, we don't like it, you know, come back with something else. You know, if they meet the height requirements, they meet the masonry requirements, then it becomes very difficult again for staff to, you know, to say, no, we don't like it. Again, you know, if that is the case, the staff doesn't like something, they have the ability to appeal to the Planning and Zoning Commission. So that option does exist even now.
Mayor, to put it simply, you cannot guarantee
that this gentleman will be satisfied. And I think...
Yes, we cannot guarantee that.
That's right.
The council cannot guarantee that.
That's right. Your vote, your motion, conditionalizing, it will not, you cannot make, he's asking for a guarantee, and you cannot do that.
Or this will come back to you guys with the design, and you guys, so this basically it?
It won't come back to us.
Will not come back to you guys.
You'd have to work with staff.
That's staff level. Facade plans and whatnot.
We do have you signed up, and we will call your names in just a moment, if you'll just be patient.
Yeah, I mean, it appears to me as though we're going to have to allow other people to speak because there are enough questions right now.
It's definitely one question about the design. If somebody can speak about the design, because I was here the last meeting, and it was 30 people speaking about, you know, freedom and
right.
how much we love American things. That's all. We love American also and everything like that. So if anybody's going to speak direct to the issue, you know, I think it'll be progress. Like I said, I'm 99.9%. If they can assure to me this will be, okay, harmonious with the surroundings, I'll walk away.
But
I would take the word also.
Okay, and let me try to position this the right way. In all due respect to the typical Texan look, they're not going to come in with a cowboy that's 40 foot high.
I mean, I understand.
I'm serious.
And that's what I'm not looking for that.
All right. And you don't have to applaud. I'm trying to say that in this city, if you go by Hall Office Park, there are some people who may like the new big piece of red art on the toll road and some who may not. In your particular case, I understand your concern. What we're trying to tell you is that at this point, we cannot guarantee you that you will like what they do.
And I'm not asking for that. My point is, right now, I believe it's here. I just want them to just bring it to the middle. It's not going to be perfect, you know, and things like that. But at least if they just bring to the middle, or at least they assure me, is I show you a picture there. You know, if it's that picture is going to be right in the front on Independence, okay, and two fronts, I think that's a little bit too much. I personally will have a hard time to live next, you know, to do something like that. And I think they would definitely appreciate the value of my property.
Okay.
So that is the only concern I have. Okay. I'm a reasonable person. I want this to happen for them. I want them to build the temple there. I just want to make sure it's not by making them happy, it's not going to hurt, you know, the value and you know, the neighborhood, basically. It's not so much myself.
If this is drawn the way that the drawing is, Scott, I can't put a measurement on there from Independence, but I don't know how far back would this be if it's done to the way the drawing would be. It's not shown as being on, right on Independence.
No, it is not.
Actually, the temple's in the middle of the property, it looks like. Is the temple the back building?
No, sir. The temple is building B.
The second one right here.
Which is this structure right
okay.
here.
Okay.
That distance looks to be approximately. Thank you.
About 150 feet back.
Say from the. What would be the new eastern edge of the right-of-way for Independence, that would look to be almost 300 feet back. So from
here to approximately here, that's not right.
From right here in front of the parking.
Right into here, going back like this to about this point in here, that's 300 feet.
This just from this point, I'm going to try
from
and
that
get
point, yeah.
from that point back is 300 feet.
Where would the And the applicant can probably answer this. Where would the statues in question be?
The first point to mention is that they're not statues. We're not having any statues. It is a building, and it's got steeples just like a church would. The only difference is it's got a few of them instead of just one in the front. So what you're seeing in front of you is the horizontal view. What you will see from Independence is just one steeple.
That's good. You can actually touch that screen where
okay.
they might be.
So what the yeah. one steeple that you will see mainly from Independence is right there where that blue mark is, and the drawing that you're looking at was the horizontal, they, what you would see from the
side. I don't think they saw the second pass. You're talking about this drawing?
That's correct. Okay. That's right. Okay, and we also have the engineers with us that have helped us to draw these, so they can certainly answer any questions about footage.
I think that's what he was talking about. If yeah. if we have people that want to address the one issue he has, it might behoove us to do that first.
Okay.
If you answer those his questions, then.
Sure. Okay.
Who do we have? Is this gentleman signed up to speak?
Yes.
And he is.
Does he wish to speak?
This is Joseph Sagel with Half Associates.
Okay, and he's signed up to speak?
Yes.
All right, would you give your name and your address then, please?
My name's Joseph Sagel with Half Associates, 3801 Parkwood Boulevard, Frisco, Texas, 75034, Suite 500. I'm an EIT involved with this project. I'd like to kind of speak briefly on two issues that were mentioned, one regarding the parking. A vast majority of this property, I mean, is green space currently, as what we're showing right now. The gentleman before was correct with it being about 300 feet. That would be from the actual wall. If you look there, there's a wall, about a 3-4 foot high wall surrounding the actual temple itself. That wall is about 300 feet to the edge of the future Independence. And then the actual temple itself would be about 310 to 320 feet further back.
You can use that touch screen and if you need
so
to draw on it.
The actual temple itself is this mm-hmm. right there.
Okay.
So as far as its overall size and over, if you feel it, it's really large. I mean, it's a small portion of that property that we're showing right there, and you can actually see the size of the actual structure, the enclosed structure. They're highlighted in blue.
So what is going to be built between Independence and the temple?
Between Independence and the temple, currently we're showing a large green area with a walking path to, there's an existing metal shed that we're actually looking to redo and kind of match, make it, improve it, stucco. This is an existing building located right here. And there would be actually a sidewalk connecting the two of those. And then the rest of the area there would in fact be green space, just sod. And of course, I mean landscaping across a large portion of the property.
What's in the back of the property, back here at the very back?
In the back of the property, that is kind of a special events center.
It's an occasional use, maybe for weddings or receptions, something like that. That's not going to be in use necessarily every day. The main temple that you hear, so the small structure, is what would be open during the day for worship, and the building in the back is an occasional use.
What's the height of that building?
40 feet.
Mm-hmm. Any other questions of Mr. Sagel?
And what's between the two? Is that just green space also?
Yes, the area between what we're calling building B, which is in the middle, and building C, which is at the rear of the property, is a large green space area. And of course, I mean, we'll have drives connecting the two and a fire lane looping around building C.
And the two items that you were talking about earlier that are 40 feet, where is this on the diagram? You said it was part of the building itself.
Excuse me?
The two items are the two parts of the building that are going to be 40 feet in the front building, the temple.
Where are those located?
Yes. Can you clear the screen? Mr. Mayor, can you clear the screen? Oh, there you go. Where is those items that he's has concerned about?
These.
It went to white.
That's what I was thinking about. I'm trying to get somebody to point it out.
Those will be 40 feet.
Yeah.
And.
So they're not attached to the building. You said that a while ago they would be attached to the building.
Right. They are, this is one concrete slab that you see right here.
Okay.
This is all one concrete slab. And we have our main worship facility here. And then this will be just a 3-foot courtyard type setup.
So they're not actually attached to the building. They're separated from the building.
Okay, correct.
Okay.
Okay, are there any other questions of Mr. Siegel? Thank you.
That's what it looked like on here.
I guess my question is do we need to have the continuation of the public hearing with all these people to speak? Do you have now a better understanding? Do you wish to not withdraw? Is it your preference? I guess I'm looking for what your preference is here.
No,
because I mean, you know, we're not trying to get you to do anything one way or another. It's your decision. So,
I guess I'm okay with, so I'll withdraw my objection to it.
Okay. Scott, when they build this wall, is there also a requirement to plant trees along the wall? Is that a requirement that we have?
You're talking about the wall here along the north
wall. The 8-foot wall. Is there a requirement once they build the wall? Is there also a tree requirement?
There is actually no screening requirement between a church and a agricultural residential property. What if they choose to build the wall, which it sounds like they are willing to do, that would the what they had originally proposed was a living screen of much more solid plant materials. If this were a commercial project where you had a screening wall, the commercial side would also have to have trees planted, I believe it's 30 feet on center along that wall. That would be something you could set as a requirement if you so chose.
Scott, can you clear one thing up for me, please? The 123 parking spaces, are those all on this property or is that shared with the property?
No, the 123 spaces are all on this property.
Okay. And in the picture I looked at, there was access from this property south to property owned by Rejoice Lutheran Church.
Yeah, that's at this point here.
My concern right there is if that land south is sold, because I guess it's been sold several times, if that goes away, does that access stay with the property?
We require cross access between most, if not all, non-residential uses unless there is some specific need for not having a connection. So yes, we would require that the connection be there.
Okay. Yeah, don't most cross access agreements, once they're established, go with the land, not with the owner?
Yeah, they are essentially platted.
Yeah, so it stays.
They're platted as fire lane and access easements. In this case, one of the stipulations that you have in your in the recommendation from the Planning and Zoning Commission was that two points of access be provided from Independence to be able to facilitate the traffic in and out. So they would be required to construct this point, and then here is their second point down here. They would actually have to work with the adjacent property owner, if it's not Rejoice Lutheran or whoever it is, to construct the second point of access.
But the bottom line is that has to be in before a CO will be approved.
Yes, sir.
And have they already worked, have y'all already, I saw on the PNZ when I watched the CD that Rejoice Lutheran got up and spoke, you have already got that in motion?
Correct.
Okay.
We're already working with each other to make sure that that gets done, but we've also met the city requirement that says even if that property is sold, that we would be required to go ahead and continue that up.
And if I remember right on the CD also, y'all agreed that the parking for the 123 spaces would be built as the first phase, I mean, all at once in the first phase. Is that right, Scott? If I saw, I just didn't want you to sit too long. If I saw the PNZ, if I understood
yes,
the request.
I believe the applicant here was had confirmed during the meeting that they were more than willing to construct all 123 spaces with the first phase of construction.
And Scott, what is the propose between the residential, this area along here?
Southern boundary.
The southern and eastern boundaries, what is that proposed this year? Yes.
And here.
Proposed as in, is in
that
what?
A screen, any type of screen there or?
A living screen.
And, okay, and so the applicant was only discussing an 8-foot wall on the northern.
Separate his property. Yeah.
That's correct, along the northern property line.
Which is not required by code, but they're agreeing.
Like again, the applicant, because it's a church, and what we really look at is more of the use to use. Again, you're looking at a residential to essentially a residential. In that case, the screening requirements, because the zoning being literally the same, there is no screening requirement. The applicants had come forward and agreed to do living screens along the north and south, or excuse me, yes, the north, south, and eastern property lines.
So they will be putting in a living down the north and the south and east, and they've agreed to the 8-foot wall, which is even more than is required of the Rejoice Lutheran.
Yes.
But I guess the basis of my question is, you know, I applaud the applicant for trying to make a concession here, but if we're forcing them to put an 8-foot wall there, are we in any way hindering this development or creating a bigger problem? You know, if we ask them to put an 8-foot wall when a living screen was a better solution to begin with.
I mean, as far as, I mean, that's an option. If the applicant is willing to work that, to agree to construct the wall, then, you know, that is something that, you know, can be that's worked out through, you know, the council approval. Since they're not obligated to construct a wall, they're going above and beyond what the ordinance would require.
But your position is you wouldn't have a problem if they did build an 8-foot wall there. It wouldn't hinder any development that would future happen. I guess I understand that they're going above and beyond by agreeing to do so. What I just want to make sure is we're making an improper decision there by forcing them to do it. If
well,
so chose.
I don't think you're forced. First of all, I don't think you're forcing. I think they're agreeing to do so. You wouldn't have any difference than say if this was a commercial retail center backing up to a residential subdivision. Again, you know, they could build a 6 to 8 foot wall. You know, in all honesty, I think that a church is probably makes a better neighbor than, say, a commercial center does, just from noise and light and everything else that goes with it.
Well, yeah, which I agree with that. I don't know, maybe I'm not being clear, but I just, looking at this diagram and seeing a living screen on the eastern and the southern, and then we're gonna build this huge brick wall, 8-foot wall, all the way across. I'm trying to visualize that, if that is going to be more of an eyesore and make them appear less open to the community than what was originally proposed by staff, which is a fence. And if you're telling me that you don't think
so. Wasn't proposed by staff. The fence was proposed by the applicant, and the applicant is saying, to meet the requirement of the northern property owner for support, they are willing to build that wall.
Well, I guess what I'm saying is, as it's presented in the diagram, it was a living screen.
No requirement. There's no screening requirement at all there.
Right, and the living screen
isn't even required. They've agreed to it, but it's not required either.
Well, that, okay, I'm just reading this where it just says proposed living screen.
It does, but it's not required.
They have agreed to that in their discussions with staff, and that's why that appears on the document. But they're not, with a living screen consists of plant material only. It does not consist of a wall, a fence, or even a wrought iron or tubular steel fence. It's just a living material.
It's not a physical barrier.
Right, and that's what I'm asking is, the discussion here tonight was approving this subject to the applicant's willingness to put an 8-foot wall, that he would withdraw his request subject to that. And what I'm asking is, do we want to go down that road? That is what I'm trying to answer for myself, is even though they showed a willingness to go above and beyond, is that really the right decision? I mean, yes, they've said they would. Doing a living screen is even going above and beyond what would normally be required, but unless I misunderstood the discussion with the gentleman who opposed it, he's withdrawing his request subject to the 8-foot wall.
That is correct.
That's right.
That was a negotiation.
That's what he said he was willing to do. And he may not even be here anymore. He's still here. I'm sorry.
So I
thought someone left and I thought it was you. I'm sorry. So.
And so my comment is, has adequate thought been put into if council chose to go that road, saying we will approve this subject to that request? My question to you is, has that been thought out as far as would that be an adequate solution to this? I just don't want to vote on something and then come back down the road and say that we made the wrong choice there, that now we've got this long brick wall that is closing this church off from the community and is more of an eyesore than what should have been, what was originally proposed.
But it's closing it off from his property, which if it is developed is his choice, is his property.
All right, we have a situation where the gentleman who opposed this has now said he has withdrawn this on the basis of putting the wall up and the other conditions that we talked about there. Now, if we're back into talking about whether or not the wall is there or not, then we have to bring the gentleman back up to say, if you don't get a wall, then are you maintaining your opposition to this? And if he's maintaining his opposition to this, then you require 5 out of 6 council members to approve it.
That's right.
Right.
I mean, we've got a circular argument.
No, but I don't believe that you need to bring him up. If council decides that somebody wants to make a motion without the wall, it requires 5 out of 6 votes. If you want to go with the wall, then his withdrawal of his opposition stays in place, and it would only require a simple majority. It just depends on what motion is made up here by somebody, if and when we get to that point.
And that was my question of staff, is the impact of the wall. I mean, is it a concern? Is it not? Is it something that I shouldn't be worried about?
As far as staff is concerned, no. I mean, we don't, there is, in our opinion, it really comes down to more of a personal preference. I mean, I personally find living screens prettier than masonry walls. Does that create an issue? No, because again, they're above and beyond what we would have required them to do in the first place. So, from a standpoint of a masonry screening wall, there are hundreds of them throughout the city. Most of them along major thoroughfares. So the having a masonry screening wall that separates the two properties, staff does not feel that, you know, that there really is any issue there.
Mayor, may I suggest that if he's withdrawn and no one wants to speak since he's withdrawn, that we close public hearing.
Where I was going next.
I knew it.
I apologize if I can interrupt just for a moment, because we have done a lot of chasing our tail here.
Right.
I think for a point of clarification, two things need to be, it doesn't impact what you have to do. It may impact what you choose to do as a council once you close. What I'm hearing is the gentleman that was in opposition would withdraw his protest if this 8-foot wall is built. And that's the only reason he would withdraw his protest, and that's the only basis for his protest. I would like for him to just confirm that for you so that you have that of record and hold that. Secondly, then, I would recommend that the council hear from the applicant, that the applicant would willingly place a condition or a stipulation on the SUP that they would be required to put the 8-foot wall up should the council choose to do that. So you have 2 points of clarification for you.
So both of you come back up and restate your agreement. In other words, since we've talked so much.
If that's what your agreement is.
If that's what your agreement is.
Yes, sir.
Here comes.
And just for the record,
yes,
state
sir.
Your name.
Yes, again. Sir. Antonio Carlos Pecorari, 11900 Independence. Yes, that is exactly what I'm thinking.
Could you state that for the record?
Yes. State. Yes, if you build the 8-foot fence high to separate my property from the temple, I will withdraw my rejection.
Okay. An 8-foot masonry fence, is that correct? Non-living.
Right, an 8-foot masonry fence, not a living screen. Right. Okay.
My name is Lakshmi Tamala, 12030 Independence Parkway, Frisco, Texas, 75035. We understand Mr. Precaria's request, and if council feels that this is a valid and okay request, we are willing to go forward with building an 8-foot masonry wall. I do agree that a live screen would be prettier. I think it would leave us more open to the public, but again, if the council feels that that is what we should do, we will build an 8-foot masonry wall.
Okay, thank you. Now, is that all you need?
Needed to hear?
Kind of, sort of. You didn't like that if, did you?
No.
Okay. I don't like that. Because what I'm hearing is if it's putting it back on you.
Right.
Okay. So. It's not. You can't require it if the applicant is revising their request to say that we are willing to place that stipulation on to get a protest removed.
So the way you need to state it then would be, yes, we agree. We agree to build the 8-foot wall.
No. They don't need.
No, you don't have to.
Nope, you don't have to do it.
No, she doesn't.
Do
have
not.
To do it.
Okay.
But you're saying.
And then let me complicate a little bit more. You guys may not, these other people may be giving up their right to speak at a public hearing when you guys may not even be considering this 8-foot wall that you don't have to consider. I just need you to understand that if the council is going to entertain a motion after you hear clearly from the applicant and the one person protesting, and if you feel like it looks as though you're going to vote based on that concession, then none of these other people may want to speak. But these other people have an opportunity to be heard. Today is their day of reckoning, and they have to be heard today before you close this public hearing.
Call for other people to speak.
So you want to open this up for everybody to speak before we do that?
I think we should wait and see what statement comes.
Yeah, we'll need to see what their revised statement is.
So are we waiting for Lakshmi to?
Yeah, you are in a public hearing right now.
Right. I know that.
Did we open the public?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, we did. I got a little lost in all this.
People have a chance to speak. Call them in. They're on the street. Let them come up.
Just going to listen to
me. Okay. What's going on? Do you need some legal advice? Mm-hmm. You need some legal advice?
Sir, can I speak for a moment?
Just call them in.
The only reason I ask is because I live a stone's throw from the property, too.
Your name is?
My name is Seth.
Hold on. Do we want to open this up to everybody to speak now?
It's a public hearing right,
right.
now.
Right. Okay. And I need to know your name, please.
Yeah. My name is Satish Varlamani, and I live on 12407 Salt Grass Lane, Frisco, Texas.
Did you fill out one of these cards?
Yes, ma'am. I did. Yeah.
Go ahead. Go ahead and speak.
Yeah. Yeah, it's about this wall. You know, I want to cut the chase and come to that. And I have about 5 or 6 points, but I think a moot point right now. So regarding the wall, I live a stone's throw from the property too. I live on Salt Grass Lane, which would be right to the east of the Sith Temple, I think. So, I mean, I personally don't feel that the wall is the right thing. I do support the temple, just like how I said in the card. I don't know what else to say. Aesthetics, like just like how Scott has summarized everything, is something that we can argue about all day, but we cannot come to an agreement. But regarding the wall, that's also part of aesthetics. And just like how that gentleman stood his position, Jeff Cheney, you know, he said, is this the right thing? I'm asking the same question. Is this the right thing for my property? I am in support for the temple, and my personal feeling is this wall is not the right thing for the surrounding properties.
Okay, thank you. Thank you very much. Do you want me to call these names, or does someone else wish to speak? We have 21 people who have signed up. I can call each name, or if you wish to speak, come forward and state your name, please.
Venkat Mulukutla, 9817 Bradford Grove Drive, Frisco, Texas, 75035. In fact, I spoke on the council meeting in the first place, and today I just wish to say just a few words here. That is, this project is for a good cause. It's for progress and prosperity. And on top of this, I see that you guys had patience to hear for about 40 minutes on opposition, but we have like more than 40 people. All our taxpayers, myself including. I'm myself a taxpayer, I'm a citizen here. And it's like kind of injustice meted out. That's what I feel. Because you guys are trying to consider on one single opposition, try to make your movements, try to cut certain things, make adjustments. But what I feel is, if that is the case, I see that it's not fair. I am for this, I am just 2 miles away from this project. This is for a good cause. And there are some monuments, if you know that. I mean, you know that pretty much on Stonebrook Parkway, there is a huge monument which is 100 feet tall. And just for 40 feet, within Frisco regulations, this project is being built. But still, I see that there are a lot of objections going around. But finally, I want to say, I'm for this project, and I see there's a lot of unfair things going around, but there are a lot of monuments more than 100 feet within Frisco City on Stonebrook Parkway right there. I'm for it. Thank you.
Just so you understand, we're not going to not have anyone speak. We'll speak if it takes an hour and a half. I mean, this is what we've done on other items, and everybody who signed up to speak can sign up and speak. What we were trying to do is if there was an agreement, some of the council members felt if there was an agreement, we didn't need to go through all that. We obviously are at a point where there's some disagreement, so if we want everyone here to speak, they're certainly welcome to speak. That's what we'll do.
Yeah, that's fine. Thank you.
Okay. We could do that.
Can we stand if they disagree with the wall?
Almost done, yeah. Your name, please?
My name is Siva Sankravel, and I live in 3630 Shell Ridge, Frisco, 75034. Just wanted to let the council know that I'm in support of this project. And to cut to the chase, generally, the society is about, you know, we don't want to be secluded. And in my opinion, as an engineer, I find it a masonry wall being less aesthetically pleasing to most of the people than a regular greenery that kind of provides you a visual separation. And but if the property owner feels that's the only way that it can be done, I personally would request the council to think what's good for the city and do what that is best for the city. And once again, you know, if you have a masonry structure, as the previous gentleman who spoke here, it kind of makes any place that is surrounded by a masonry structure very secluded, or and that's not exactly the intention of this project to start off with. So it'll make it kind of isolated, which is, it's an open society, it is open for everyone. And so I would like it to have all the facets and elements, architectural elements, that it makes it as open as possible. And that is my personal input to it. But if it comes to decision making, and if that's the only sticking point, I would request the committee to weigh in and make a final decision. Thank you.
Sir, what was your address again, please?
3630 Sheldridge, Siva, Sankravel.
Okay, thank you.
Did you say thank you, ma'am?
Yes.
Yes, okay.
Sorry.
Is there someone else who wishes to speak, sir? Yes. And did you complete a card?
Yeah, I did. Okay. I did. My name is Ganesh Venkatramani. I live in 9425 Rollator Road, apartment 824. Been a resident of Frisco since 2002. Wanted to basically say two things. The other gentleman said about this, on the other side of Stonebrook, there is this religious place that's more than 100 feet tall. And one of the things is, we live in a diverse society and each one has its own rules, regulations according to their religious beliefs. And aesthetically pleasing everyone is stuck. Dr. Joyner said, it's not possible. I mean, some religions have their preferences, some religions have their rules which have to be followed. So when you're building a structure, you follow certain structure, certain things that have been followed for a long time, historically, and you build it according to that. And the second thing regarding the wall, I personally don't think a wall is necessary, because my personal opinion is it reduces the value. It's more of like you're segregating yourself from your neighbors. And I think we live in a beautiful city. I moved to Frisco because of what Frisco is, what stands for. It's a beautiful place, it's crime free, the people are great. You know, we have great people living here, and I don't think we need to separate one thing from the other just because it's a different kind of structure, be it a temple or a mosque or anything else. We don't have to separate ourselves from. We can make it more aesthetically beautiful by putting either tall trees or some kind of bushes that would be more pleasing, rather than building a wall. I think the wall is an eyesore. That's my personal feeling.
Okay. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
If everyone else that's getting ready to come up and speak is going to come up and say, we would prefer not to have the wall, I just need you to come up and say, we don't want the wall, okay? I mean, that, or I support not having a wall. If that's, go ahead, sir, I'm sorry. Your name?
Yes, sir. I am V.V. Prakash Rao. I am the chairman of Tattva Yoga Center for the USA. So I just want to say a few words.
And I'm sorry, did you complete one of these?
Sorry. Yes, I okay. did. Yeah. I am from Mississippi, but I'm the chairman of this Dattva Yoga Center, so that's the reason I thought I'd just say a few words. I heard the objections from the gentleman, and we agreed with the assumption that we wanted to be good neighbors, and so we tried our best to go beyond what city requires. But at the same time, as we deliberate and think about it, I feel that probably it would be an eyesore, and we are blocking everything from the other side. And basically, that wall is almost like a a wall of separation between neighbors. I'm not sure that would be the right one, even though we agreed, and if the council feels that is the way to do it, we have no questions about it. But at this time, we feel that is not the right way to do it. Thank you.
Thank you very much.
Good evening, everybody. My name is Ram Maji, resident of Frisco, 9921 Buckingham Lane, Frisco, Texas, 75035. I'm here to say, like, just a few words. I'm just, like, and I want to say that this project, like, who are the chairman, like, you know, it's a great project. I mean, it's really great. I mean, it's like, you know, I mean, I just found this, like, a few days back. I read my wife's email, and I found this, and I'm really excited about this project. And I'm here to say that, like, you know, as a Frisco resident for the past 7 years, strongly in bold support the project, but at the same time, like, I don't support the wall. My personal preference from my family and everything, or like from the meditation point of view, it's better to go green. Thank you.
My name is Neelish Mahindale. I'm a resident of 4173 History Circle. I'm also a physician here in Frisco. I have a medical practice in Frisco that I also own, so I have two addresses, actually. I'm in support of the project, as from what I understand, just from hearing this horse being beaten for a while. It sounds like this gentleman made a proposal for a compromise. It sounds like DYC at this point probably doesn't agree with the proposal. I don't want to put words in their mouth, but that's at least the feeling I'm getting, and I agree. I think the wall is probably not the most aesthetically pleasing thing. At this point, I think it's a great idea, the project itself, and I really think the council now needs to decide, either support it on its own merit, or DYC needs to decide we're going to make a compromise and support it on the compromised merit. But thank you. I certainly hope you would support it on its own merit.
All right, thank you.
My name is Ryan Chaudhary. I reside at 9655 Aristocrat Lane, Frisco, Texas, 75034. I've been living in Frisco for the last 4 years, and I strongly support this project. My point was about cultural and architectural pluralism in a city. I mean, as earlier we started the talk about toning down the structures. I mean, if everybody brought in their design and started toning down, then we'll have the entire city look the same. We'll not have diverse architectures around the city. I mean, even driving by wouldn't be a pleasure. When the talk about wall came up, I was thinking of some of the beautiful churches and structures that we have around the city, and just started thinking, what if there were walls all around the structures? You drive by, and if every neighbor start protesting and you start constructing walls around any structure that doesn't look like other box or other different kind of structures around the city, then there'll be no beautiful architecture. There'll be nothing open that you can see. I mean, unless you have to be a member of particular church or on an organization to walk inside of those walls to see what's going on. So I strongly think the wall is probably not the right way to go, unless that's the decision we are forced to make because, I mean, of having to put that in the first place. I think having a green structure around it will naturally blend in with the nature around there. And the whole purpose of having a spiritual place, I mean, I see that having green around it is a lot better. Thank you.
Thank you very much. Sir, yes.
Mr. Mayor, my name is Vijay Kumar Kancharla. I live in Panther Creek Estates in subdivision. So I'm in support of this project.
What is your address, please?
11395 Jasper Drive, Frisco, Texas.
Thank you.
And this is, I believe this is a very welcoming project and going to attract a lot of Indians to Frisco. And by having a religious temple nearby, and our value as well as price of the property is going to go up, and it's going to be a very nice neighborhood. I would request gentleman Mr. Procario to negotiate with us again and come to the terms, because we have a larger community, especially there is around 100,000 Indians, and most of them love to visit Hanuman Temple because he is one of the famous Indian gods in Indian subcontinent as well as Southeast Asia. So it's going to attract a lot of Indians and make us wealthy here. And secondly, I respect the citizens' rights. So his concerns I had, and we would like to do anything that he would, you know, he likes us to do in order to protect our religious beliefs as well as his citizen rights. Thank you.
Thank you. Is there anyone else to speak?
Hi, my name is Vijaya Kollapaneni. I live at 14731 Snowshield Drive, Frisco. I strongly support this project, and I strongly support not having wall in between the community and the temple. I am very happy and excited about this temple since I live in the same street at Independence and 121 intersection. I think this temple will be a wonderful asset for the Frisco community. Same like me, many of my colleagues moved from California 2 years back, and some of them who are yet to purchase homes. Since they have heard that a temple may be coming up in Frisco, they are already considering Frisco to be their home. These families now want to move to Frisco are well-educated, family-oriented, and education-oriented. Having this temple in Frisco will help Frisco to grow in the right direction. It is almost a half-day project for us every weekend if we want to go to Hindu temple in Irving, where there is no wall or there are no other constraints in between the community and the temple. There are so many communities and so many living houses there close to Irving temple. Having temple in Frisco will save our valuable time and will help to plan the weekend better. Not only for Frisco people, I would say this temple will make Indian community people happy who are in Plano, Allen, Richardson, and Makani areas, since this will be closer than Irving Hindu temple. And also it will make them to think about moving to Frisco permanently. Thank you so much for giving an opportunity to talk.
Thank you. Anyone else that wishes to speak, if you would come down front and get closer to the podium, I would appreciate it. It will speed up the process a little bit. If you please come down front. It's like most churches, the first couple rows are empty, so there's plenty of room down here. So.
My name is Rama Somanchi, and I have been living in Frisco area for past 4 or 5 years.
Your address, please.
And my address is 11700 Lebanon Road. Thank Frisco, you. Texas 75035. I completely wholeheartedly support this project. Of course, I'm a member of the DYC, Datta Yoga Center, one of the members. So I am biased in that way in supporting it. But at the same time, I want to stress a couple of things which I did not like from the previous conversation from the gentleman. Nothing against personal, but one of them is to tone down that structure. My belief is that you have more churches, more synagogues, more mosques, and more diversified, taller buildings, not all these unnecessary structures which are very high just for commercial value, but have buildings that are high for spiritual value. Doesn't matter if it is Hindu, Muslim, Christian, or Catholic. Doesn't matter any denomination. Let us have them more so that we have a more peaceful society, more progressive society, and spiritually oriented society. Let us not tone down anything for the sake of eye pleasing, because then in that case we have to apply to every construction, every structure available. And second one is, I can completely understand his point of view from the noise and traffic, and if the city and as our center can address those issues, that will be good. And let us not have any more walls just for having some kind of separation between the community and the people. The Berlin Wall has come down in 1980s under the Reagan's leadership. Let us not build more walls.
Thank you.
That's my personal belief. And again, I support, I'm not objecting his point of view. As a common citizen, he has his rights and he wants to have his peaceful life. And we all want to have that kind of peaceful mentality, peaceful spirituality within ourselves. And this center helps, trust me, not only for people of Indian origin, but people of any origin, all the humanity in the global sense. So I support this project with no wall. If wall is not required by law, let us not have any wall here. Thank you.
Thank you.
I am Jay Prakash. I live in Frisco, 3424 Cumberland Lane, 75034. I'd like to make one point. I'm not going to talk about churches or mosque or anything. And people are accepting water tanks. People are living besides water tank. And if we start building fences against each and every water tank, the city budget will not be enough. I would like to conclude with this one saying, if you start changing your look, the way you look at things, the things you look at will change. Thank you.
Thank you very much. I appreciate it.
Hello, my name is Hari Madiraju. I live in 10103 Promontory Drive, Frisco, Texas. And I constructed my house, basically like Tuscany, in Tuscany Meadows, by means of old Indian architecture called Vastu. You believe me or not, in the regulations of Frisco City. And I am a strong supporter of this project, and I believe in the traditional Vastu. According to that, the architecture of this temple, as well as the north wall, north side of the wall, is not permitted. So I would like to vote against that wall. So that's all I would like to say. My name is Hari. Thank you.
Thank you.
Good evening. My name is Anand Chalapa. I live in 8311 Townbridge Drive, Frisco, 75035. I'm not in favor of the wall. And I'm totally in support of this project.
Okay, thank you very much. Appreciate it.
My name is Vamsi Krishna Kotla. My address is 9269 Prestwick Drive, Frisco, Texas 75034. I strongly support this project without a wall. And I have been a resident of Frisco for the last 2.5 years, and it would mean a lot for me and my wife to have this temple in Frisco. As somebody earlier said, it's like a half a day project for us to visit a temple in Irving. So this temple would mean a lot to us to bind with our community and build a strong community in Frisco. So I'm in support of this project without a wall. Thank you.
Thank you.
My name is Gopal Ponengi. I live in Frisco, 7657 Raven Hill Drive. I have a family. I have two daughters, 7-year-old and 1-year-old. Every weekend or every alternate weekend, I have to go all the way to Irving because of the Indian Hindu temple that's there. So with this temple coming here, I don't need to make that long trip and then spend half a day like my previous friends have said. One more thing is, whenever we go to temple, we spend a lot of money outside the temple. When we go to Irving, we eat dinner and other things. Last night, we did the same thing too because it was New Year's. And the money we spent in Olive Garden, which actually belongs to Frisco because it should not go to Irving. So having a temple like this will invite more and more people to come and spend in Frisco, which will be good for all of us. As far as the wall is concerned, I think the Datta Yoga Center people are more passionate about the project as against the cost for the wall. That's why they said that, you know, if everyone agrees, then they do not have any problem in paying it. But I think that's the tax they are paying for not following the mainstream faith that's being observed here. So I think I would like all of you to consider this as a very valuable project and then do your best. Thank you.
Thank you very much. Okay, there's no one else to speak then. We'll cause a We'll ask the public hearing to be closed. Did you have something else, Lixma?
Yes, earlier you had asked Mr. Precario to come and speak, and it also asked me to do the same at the end. So I'd just like to say that, you know, previously when Mr. Precario and I spoke, we had agreed to do the wall, and we still hope, we want to be a good neighbor, basically. We've already said that we would do that, and again, like I said, if this is a fair request, then we are still willing to build the wall, but I do appreciate everybody's comments because I do agree with the comments that it may not look the best, but again, we would like to be good neighbors and have a good relationship with our neighbors.
Okay, thank you. If you would come up, and I want to clarify one thing, and then we're going to call this to a vote. And what I want to clarify is that you either are withdrawing or you are not withdrawing, and whether or not the wall is an issue or not an issue. And I just want to make sure, as our attorney said, that the basis of a withdrawal is dependent upon the wall, and if you're not getting the wall, you're not withdrawing. I just want to clarify that.
That's correct. If I'm not getting the wall, I'm not withdrawing my opposition.
Okay.
And I also like to speak. I'm very pleased you're an honorable person. Okay. I understand everybody has opinion, but also as a landowner, the wall will be protecting my land. Okay. I have nothing with your religious. I welcome you to Frisco. My family welcome you. The only thing, like I said to you, is it's a place wide open. It happens people walking across who have pool, who have dogs, their insurance, their liabilities. There is nothing against you personally. I just want to make sure that we don't want to isolate you from nothing. I'm a religious person like my family is. So we welcome you. The only reason we're requesting the wall is for our protection and for your protection also, okay? That's the only reason, and I'm very honorable. And
okay, thank you, sir. Okay, counsel, and if our attorney would keep me in line here, if there is a motion to...
Let's close the public hearing.
Oh, yeah, we need to close the public hearing.
Motion to close the public hearing.
Thank you.
Second.
Had so much going on, I didn't close the public hearing. So the motion was by Jim.
And Jeff.
Second by Jeff. All in favor of closing the public hearing?
Aye.
Any opposed? Motion is 6-0. So if a motion is made to accept the item number 12 and with no changes, and we have opposition to that, it has to be a supermajority vote.
Correct.
Which means 5 out of 6.
Correct.
If there's a motion made, so do we have to vote on the motion as it is first? Or you can make a motion.
You can make a motion to include
the fence. And if you make a motion to include the fence, then it needs a regular majority vote.
Simple
majority vote.
Let's say masonry wall instead of fence also.
Yes.
Masonry wall. Is there a motion on item number 12?
We're going to have any discussion.
Discussion by council.
Well, I want to say a couple of things, and the two people addressed it.
Wait a minute, I'm putting a 5-minute timer on the council too. How do you do this?
2 minutes.
Okay, go ahead.
And I stopped it, that's my right. No, basically, I appreciate what they said. First off, for y'all to understand, there are many churches, regular, whether it be Baptist, Presbyterian, or whatnot, that come forward to us, and neighbors that abut those have come and spoken either against or wanting a wall or wanting more screening. So it's not just your place of worship. We've had one on Lebanon that some neighbors were upset about expanding. It's already there, and they, you know. I think the point here is our job is we don't want or not want the wall. We don't want or not want the 40-foot high. Someone talked about the monuments. These are requests of a citizen, and we try to make the best situation for whoever. And since you only have one neighbor, and it is his home, and he's been there for a long time, of course, we're going to try and work with the two of you to do that. I liked what you said about being a good neighbor. Whether it meets his idea of good architecture or your idea of good architecture, the bottom line is it is going to impact his home. And it's going to impact other homes. If there are other homes around it, we'd have other people here. So it's not, like I said, it's basically our job is to find the best compromise that maintains the good neighbor relationship with any business. So again, this is not personal. I think it's a great project. I mean, we've recently brought in a mosque, another mosque. We've recently brought in a synagogue, other churches, a very diverse community, and we revel in that. We love that. That is the reasoning for working with these two people to try and get what will satisfy or allay any fears either one has. Those are my own comments.
Jeff?
Only additional comments I have really regard the wall. My personal position on that is I don't see use for it. I understand the objection the homeowner to the north has, but I think the screen proposed already went above and beyond what was required. I think doing that is being a good neighbor, and I don't see a reason to close them off on the northern border. If they choose to put it there, well within their right, and they can do so, but I don't see it being a reason to grant this SUP or a requirement.
Okay. Matt?
I'm not a fan of brick walls in general. I'd much rather see a living screen, but a little bit different than Jeff. And in the interest of being good neighbors and the fact that the other three sides of the property are open, I would grant the request for the brick wall, again, just in the interest of the landowner to the north making that request.
Okay, thank you, Matt. Joy?
First, I want to applaud to you all. You've done an outstanding job. You've done very well stating your cases. When we work with developers and citizens, we always have them work together because they are good neighbors, because they are going to be neighbors. And you all have been working very hard to do that. And if a citizen asked a developer that they would feel more comfortable putting up a masonry wall, then 9 times out of 10, we probably would go along with that as long as the developer would agree to it. Where this is located is basically outlining his wall or his land. It's not, I mean, you're going to be able to see the beautiful temple from Independence and all surrounding areas. So I love living walls myself, but I don't feel that it's asking a lot. And I appreciate you agreeing to do so of putting up a masonry wall.
Okay, thanks, Joy. Tony?
I love the one person who said, let's make a decision based upon the merits of the project, because really that's what we're looking at. We're looking at the use of the project, of the land for this project. I think it's a good use. Support of the church being here. They were within the guidelines as far as height limits, everything else along those lines. And then both sides, in all honesty, see, Joy's a good one. I'm going to be the bad one and kind of chastise everybody a little bit. Everybody went a little bit the other way and started getting into opinions and attitudes and things that were based upon their own personal beliefs. I mean, you have questions about architecture that nobody's going to be able to abide by or agree on. You've got questions of aesthetics. You got blocking a good thing, quote, from the other side, good neighbors. Perception that it's being built around the entire property when, as Joy points out, this is only a wall on one side. And in all due respect, to go comparing this wall to the Berlin Wall was out of line. With that being said, I think the project on its own is a good project. I welcome it in town. It is about diversity. But you do have two property owners here, and as such, we do have to take into consideration the other property owner. With the discussions I've had, with the concession being made that there would be considered a wall, safety can be an issue in terms of, in all honesty, when I first looked at the plan, I thought that was a solid wall and not a living screen wall. If nothing was there, I think I agree with most everybody else in this room that ideally it would be a living screen wall, but to try to, one gentleman even said that walls are not part of the religion, and I don't think that's accurate in all honesty. I think what's important was what goes on the property and not between property lines. So with all that being said, I would support this property, this project, but I believe that the wall being put in place is not out of line.
David?
For brevity, I agree with Councilman Chang.
Okay, all six people have been polled. I need a motion on item 12.
I'm going to move that we approve this project pending staff recommendations for coming back with SF4 zoning, cross-access and joint parking agreements in place, and the 8-foot masonry wall is agreed to by the two parties along the north property line.
Second. Okay, we have a motion by Jim, which would include the wall, SF4, cross-access. We have a second by Tony. All in favor?
Mayor?
Yes?
I just want to ask a procedural question as far as if this motion was not approved, then...
You make another one.
Then what would happen?
Brilliant.
Then you can make another...
You could.
Mm-hmm. But you'll trigger the supermajority.
Does that answer your question?
Yes.
Okay, we had a motion by Jim and a second by Tony. All in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
One, two, three, four. So we have a nay by David and by Jeff.
Motion carries.
And this motion then carries because we had a withdrawal of the protest.
And welcome to Frisco.
So the motion would pass.
Wait, you said we had a withdrawal of the. Mm-hmm.
Yes.
With this motion. The objection was withdrawn.
We had a withdrawal of the opposition with the agreement to build an 8-foot wall. The motion included an 8-foot wall. With the withdrawal, we needed a simple majority vote, which we have, and the vote is 4-2 in favor. So it is approved with the 8-foot wall.
And welcome to Frisco.
Thank you. We do appreciate this many people coming out and spending this amount of time. We like to think that we hear everyone, and we have spent about an hour and a half on this item. And so I think we've heard from everyone, and we appreciate everyone being here. We had 40-some people fill out cards that didn't wish to speak, 20-some people that did want to speak. So we appreciate the number of you who were here tonight. So thank you very much.
And Nan, if you would just let the record show that my nay vote was in regards to the wall and not the
not
church.
Not against the data center, yeah.
You and David were against the wall?
Right.
Okay.
Right, but not against. I think that's important, too, for y'all to understand that Councilman Cheney and Councilman Prince did not vote against the data yoga center. They voted against the wall. They, yeah.
Thank you. We've had a motion for a 5-minute bio break, so if everyone would be back in 5 minutes.
While they exit.
Don't knock down the walls.